Good morning, y'all. Happy Saturday. And first of all, I want to say happy June 19th to everybody out there. You know, today is one of the holidays that President Biden campaign passed for the Emancipation Proclamation and freeing of slaves. So now we now have our own free day for all you Afro-American brothers and sisters out there. Happy, happy Juneteenth day. So I decided to come on here. I mean, because not all Black lives matter, but all lives matter to me because I am not just Black, but I'm Italian and Black. So I'm multiracial, and, you know, but at the bottom of the line, you know, when I have to write down, you know, what my ethnic background is, it's going to always be Blacks. But guys, you know, in today's society, we got to look past the color thing, but I am happy to, for my race, that we now have a free day. So thank you so much. But getting to why I'm cooking this morning, it's because it's Saturday. I'm hungry. So I thought maybe I haven't been live for a while. Y'all hold on just for a second. I'll be right back. Always when I go live, somebody just like want to call. It better be important, too. All right. Hey, hello? What's up, Uncle Sleepy?
Oh, no, it's your cousin come to the party tonight.
Who was it?
Derek.
Oh, Derek having his birthday party?
Yeah, he having about to get shot 5 o'clock.
Oh, shit, now. What? You going?
I don't know, Safe.
Oh, what's the matter?
Huh?
What's wrong? Why?
Nothing wrong.
Oh, you just don't like to drink and hang around crowds like that, huh? Yeah, you like to be home chilling. Well,
yeah.
There ain't nothing wrong with that. Yeah, I might go.
Yeah, so I'll let you know.
Okay, what you doing today? You working today?
No, we got to take a trailer to Norwood.
You got to do what?
We got to have to take your trailer to Norwood.
You and who?
Me and the man I work with.
Mr. Buddy?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, at least you're going to Uncle JB's neck of the woods. I said, at least you're going to Uncle JB's neck of the woods. Grab my brother.
Yeah.
Well, okay then. Huh? Yeah, I know she passed. I don't know what the funeral's going to be yet, but yeah, I'm going because she was like a little sister to me, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm taking a little hard, but it hadn't set on me yet. But when I get to the funeral, you know, I'll be crying like a little baby.
Yeah. Okay. Okay,
then I'm gonna let you go. There's no question for that. Oh, I'm not gonna show up and show out, honey. I'm gonna be late. As a matter of fact, I won't even be drinking at Derek's house. Because you know I ain't barely gonna be up there. I don't have time for to get on me, honey.
Yeah,
they
got plenty of alcohol, so.
Yeah, exactly. I don't need all that alcohol in my life because I know I'll be sick for days. And me gotta go to school, no alcohol.
Yeah.
You would probably be a little natural like beer. Cause my dad is supposed to be coming down too, so you know how that goes.
Yeah. I need a call back in that room.
Are you at breakfast already?
Yeah, I'm leaving now. I'm going to Norwood.
All right, then. Have a good day. I'm sleeping.
Bye.
Well, there we have it. We have my cousin's birthday party tonight. And then one of my other little sisters, who's not really my real sister, but she's like a sister, passed away. Her name is Miss Sophie Willoughby. She, has two beautiful daughters. She's about 40 years old, and her brother came home from prison. And I don't know if all the excitement or whatever, she had a heart attack, but she had aneurysm probably about, I want to say about 25 years ago. I came home from the military, and I picked her up, and my sister had told me that she had suffered aneurysm, so it crippled her. But through it all, you know, through physical therapy, she was able to, you know, beat that thing. She had surgery and they corrected it. And she was in a wheelchair for the last 25 years, taking care of kids, you know, doing what she had to do. I mean, super trooper. I love Sophia Willoughby. She's my baby, if I had to call, because I remember when I was like 14, 15, I used to babysit her and my little kids. She was next door, my cousin's firstborn, Bud Hubbard, Bud Willoughby Hubbard, who is now deceased herself. Yeah, we lost someone so sweet, Sophia Willoughby. She wasn't even 50 years old yet, young. You know, they say the good die young. So I know she's up in heaven right now looking down on me. I love her so much. So if you guys know the word of prayer, please pray, special prayer for Sophia Willoughby and her family that they may get through this ordeal. Because anybody knows about death in the family, this your boy, our family has been through it. COVID-19 alone, I lost my uncle. And about a year ago, I lost my niece when her so-called boyfriend shot her in the head on her birthday. Lord, if I had to keep going on, I'd be on talking about death all day. But, you know, when it comes to death, that's God's thing. You know, we don't like it. We got to go through it. I just wish you guys to say a prayer for me because I am impacted by this because she's my cousin, more like a sister. But today is my other cousin's birthday. He's celebrating his 57th birthday, Derek Harrington. So, you know, my uncle was telling me, like, don't get over there and start cold cutting up because me and Derek get to drinking. Lord, we drink. That boy, see, drink me underneath the table, but he's the type of person, he's a Marine. He can drink. Trust me, he's a devil dog. I mean, when I say devil dog, he is the essence. Big old picture says, Sergeant Major Derek Harrington, Marine, United States Corps Marine. That's him. Me, I'm a little old Stacey Lee, U.S. Army. So, of course, you know, y'all drink me. I drink two glasses of champagne and I'm drunk. He can drink four bottles of tequila still standing up. So, yeah, you know, it is what it is. But getting back to the breakfast, y'all, I'm going to cook some pancakes this morning. I already got my grits on because last time I cooked breakfast, I think it was yesterday morning. You guys check out my live videos. I didn't have the grits on. So I already have the grits already pre-cooked. And what I did was put water. I had half a stick of butter. I put like 3 cups of grits in it because, you know, mom and everybody's come over for breakfast this morning. So, you know, I just want to have something to eat when they come in and come out. Because Saturday morning, that's what we do around here. We eat, move, do what we got to do, visit, say goodbye, and everybody going by 12. So, you know, when people come in now, I like to have something to eat, you know, so they won't be like, girl, what you got in there to eat? They can look at the stove and get it. So, this morning is going to be pancakes, cheese and eggs, and grits. No pork, no meat. You know, they want meat to go get there because I am now a vegetarian. Yes, I am. Doing the vegan thing, y'all. So, first thing I'm going to do is get my eggs out. And you guys, I'm going to start pre-printing the recipes for Carolina Diamond's Diner, which I'm now calling my second cooking channel. I'm going to put all the recipes, you know, in the description so you guys can see exactly what I'm doing. But today is my first video, so I'm going to go back and edit it and stand on my channel probably tonight. I'm working on my third channel, my personal channel. And I got to do a couple more channels with some other people. But hey, getting back to the cooking here, y'all. Let's get it because I'm hungry. I am looking for a bowl. This is already washed over here. Oh, just ripped itself. And while that's doing, I'm going to turn on the stove. The first hour, I'm going to turn this one on to 7 because I want my oil to actually get hot while I mix up the ingredients. Y'all don't tell me I don't have any oil because if you don't, I don't have any cooking oil. I'm in trouble. And I know I do. Don't go to improvise. I know I got some oil now. The devil is a lie. If I don't, there's other days you can cook with. Please believe me. It looks like I don't have any oil because last night I cooked me some tilapia fish and it was good. So in that case, guess what I'm going to use today? Imperial margarine. Margarine. And yes, guys, you can cook with margarine. Please believe me. I don't like to because I love my olive oil, but this morning I don't have any. So, but anyway, the show must go on, right? Gotta eat. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and cut, I say, 4 tablespoons of butter. Well, it's probably going to be the best fatty-ass pancake I ever ate in my life, but it's going to be worth it. So I'll go ahead and, you know, grease the sides. It makes it easier to clean. So I'm going to let that simmer. And y'all, can y'all believe my eyes like jacked? That's when I clean my stove. I didn't put it on properly, but I'm not going to touch it now because it's so hot. So I'm going to let that go. I'm going to put it on a 7 because I wanted to go ahead and melt properly. And then for my eggs, the same thing. I'm going to use a half stick. What's going on, Mad Max TV? Just cooking a little breakfast here. Hope you're having a blessed Saturday morning. And what I'm going to do, guys, instead of putting a whole half stick, and I'm on my diet, we're just going to go 1, 2, 3 tablespoons per egg. Cut it in half. And we use the rest of the butter stick for our pancakes. So I'm going to do just let it go. I may have too much. If that's the case, I'll take this right here and put it in the grits. But let's put this up because we don't need no more butter. Lord knows we got to do 1,000 sit-ups for this. And the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to grab my milk. I got my eggs. All right. And the most important ingredient I'm missing is the cheese. So what I'm going to do, going over here, put a little bit, I say about, not even about a half a cup of milk in my eggs. Put it to the side. I'm going to put, well, I better turn my stove, my eggs on. I'm going to put this on right here. We're going to put this on. We'll start it out with 4 because it's going to slow melt while I'm mixing everything up. But now let's get this party started, right? Have breakfast in less than 5 minutes and I'm done. So I'm going to put 4 eggs in here. Hold on, guys. Give me just a second. I'm going to get up where you can see me. I got to get my kitchen set up. I got to get me a camera with a tripod on it so I can move around freely. And one of those eye rings for that I saw at Walmart. Yeah, and a cell phone stand. Yeah. So I'm putting 3 eggs plus 1 more. I got to make me a grocery list, y'all, because I'm about out of eggs, too. Eggs and vegetable. Olive oil is what I got to get. Because I plan on doing a whole lot of cooking this summer, y'all. I'm starting my diet. So the next thing I'm going to do, guys, is go ahead and stir it up. Let me get a fork. Go ahead and break. Make sure you break the yolk, y'all, because that's what's going to give it the zest and the boom. And normally when I'm cooking cheese and eggs, I like to use powdered milk because it makes the eggs go pop. And it's pretty good. You know, makes a big difference. So what I'm going to do now is go ahead and break the egg yolk, stir it up accordingly. Y'all, it is hot this morning. It's about 100,000 degrees here in North Carolina. But guess what? It is so hot, even the damn devil in hell won't come out. So, you know, my hair is up because it's so humid. And I do have long hair, guys. So I just got it in a ponytail wrapped up because I just got out of the shower. And, you know, I don't want to be like, oh, gosh, she's sweating like hell when there's only water coming from my hair. So I had to put it up. But anyway, moving right along. I hope the weather's there great for you guys. I hope it's not so hot because I'm about to go turn the air conditioner on because I can't take it, yo. So, but in the meantime, while I'm doing this, I'm going to cut up the cheese and the eggs and cut the cheese in there. And then what I'm going to do now is just go ahead and toss the cheese inside of the bowl that I just put the eggs and milk in. Hold on, guys. Let me just set the trash can is over here. Now, in the meantime, while this is going on, I need to turn down my grits down to low because they are already done. And what I'm going to do right here is, guys, you got an iron skillet. You better hurry up and put that grease in there, which should be just enough right there. Yeah, just enough. So we're going to go ahead and just dip that in there. And what you want to do, your eggs to do is form like an omelet, okay? While that's doing it, go ahead and put your things away and wash. I love a clean kitchen, y'all. I just can't stand cooking in a nasty kitchen. I put all my things in there. And while I'm preparing to cook and when my meal is getting raw on, that's when I wash my dishes. But, you know, you might do things differently than I do. But me, it's just the way I was taught in, you know, military teach time management. When you become an E7 above, you just use those things. And, you know, it's like grit, growth, resistance, intelligence, and tenacity. You just do it at home. It saves time. Makes sense. Do it, honey. That's more time for yourself, right? So, anyway, if you know how to cook, you've been cooking a long time. You know about time management in the kitchen. Do what you got to do. Make it burn, honey. And what I'm doing right here, guys, is buttering my sides for my pancakes. Because when you cook pancakes, you don't want to be sticking to the pan unless you got a non-stick pan. So what I'm going to do is turn up a little bit and go ahead and get my pancakes ready. But I got to put it on an even aisle, so I'm going to put it like that. Yeah. Because like I said, I was cleaning my stoves, guys, and my, you know, the biggest thing in the world I hate is pushing the eyes back into the stove. That's why my next stove is going to be one of those ranges that get hot on its own. It's one of those smart stoves from Titaniums. It costs about $950. I'm going to get me one, too. They self-clean. I mean, I love, don't get me wrong, Frigidaire is cool, but when it comes to stoves, I got to have that silver stuff, honey. Get up with date with technology. Right now, I'm in the 90s with this stove, but it's cool. It do what it do. Besides, and then the oven, my oven is gone now because I done had this stove now probably about 20,000 years of my life. No, I'm just playing about 10 years, trying to make you laugh. But anyway, what I'm going to do now, guys, is try to put this right here. And I'm going to mix up my pancakes. And what I'm going to do, guys, any pancake will do. You know, you're trying to put yourself on a budget because I'm working on my master's degree. Even though I have dual degrees in telecommunications and business management, I am now working on the criminal justice with a background in IT, cybersecurity, which is going to, I got 2.5 more years before I have my PhD on all telecommunications. So, but anyway. Yeah, I got to go to school. I'm going to school with ECPI. And what I'm going to do right now, guys, is take this out because I hate to put pancakes in a box and it gets stuck in there at the bottom of the box. And then you, when you take it out, it just falls all over the floor. So I'm going to put about 2 cups in there. I mean, you can do your pancakes however you want to. Like, see, like I said, pancakes everywhere. And I'll just shake it off in the sink and put it back in the box. And this time we're using this Chest Hill waffle and pancake mix is real great. But like I said, you see that in the bottom, all that pancake stuff in there. Oh, I hate it. I really do. But anyway, getting back to the breakfast. I am going to take a little bit of milk because I love my milk. I love milk. Milk is good for you. And since I'm on a diet, this is not the whole milk. It's 2% milk. Right, y'all. Picture me rolling. Gonna get a cooking, y'all. And for my pancakes, y'all know I got to go with Miss Butterworth. Miss Butterworth. Yes, yes. Love that lady. She's been in my life for 44 beautiful years, honey. 44. And yes, I am 44. July 7th. But anyway. I was in somebody's stream and somebody said, you can't be saying. I said, what the hell I want to about my birthday. Shit. I'm in my life. You going to tell me when I can't say my birthday? Shit, I thank God for every day I was born. I don't know what's up with these ladies. I don't want to tell you my age. Well, ain't my problem that you getting old, grow old gracefully, honey. At least I am. I don't need all that makeup and all that fake eyelashes and all that. I'm myself. I ain't nothing wrong with it. I mean, that's how you guys, girls, like to do that. But me, I don't know eyelashes. Well, my eyelashes, I don't have any. I thank God what I have. Every day, every wrinkle, every gray hair, honey, I'm going to thank him. Because if it wasn't him, I wouldn't be here. So why are you ashamed by your looks? Don't you know that's why God created us differently? Can you imagine a boring world where we all look alike? It would be so boring. I thank God that I'm different, you know? Even twins are different. Everybody's like, yeah, girl, I know her. How you gonna know me more than I know myself? The devil is a lie. Some of y'all don't even know your own selves. I'm just keeping it 100, y'all. Y'all know I'm gonna keep it real with you. Now, y'all, I'm gonna stir the pancakes just right. And what I'm gonna do, y'all, I'm gonna switch out these spiders, what we call them spiders, and spider spatulas, pans. So I'm gonna move this to the side right here because I want to go ahead and get my pancakes started because my eye is uneven and it's too hot, too late to adjust now because they're all hot. So what I'm going to do right here is stir up my pancakes and put this here on the skillet, iron skillet. Please, guys, make sure you got a cool cloth or something because that right there could actually burn your extra burn mine. That's why I jumped. But what I'm going to do is go ahead and stir this up. And that's why I miss my oil because you have to watch that butter. You can really mess up your pancakes if you get it too hot. And stick it to the pan. Pancakes just won't come out right. No burnt, no ashy. We don't want that. So right now you can see my pancakes is kind of loose because I put a little bit too much milk, but that is no problem. All I'm going to do is just put the remaining pancakes in there and then put pancakes in my list. my grocery list, that is. So I need some olive oil, I need some more eggs, and I need some more pancake mix. I can actually make my own homemade pancakes, but I would go buy it. So I put a little bit more than thickening it up. That should be enough. Oh, Lord, let's turn that down a little bit. The grease begin to pop. Normally I'm prepared. I already have my ingredients already done. But since I was like, man, am I going to eat or am I going to eat some boiled eggs? I was like, I'm going to eat me some breakfast today. I've been on a diet for the last actually eating right the last week, but actually exercising since Monday. So we're going to stir it up. I'll show y'all guys what it looked like. Stir the pancakes to get all the lumps out. It's getting thick. All my eggs is already going. Y'all smelling good already. So go ahead and whip it good. It's just like I want it. It's getting thick. Yes. Now, with that being said, you move the boil around a little bit. Like so. I'm going to go ahead. My pancakes are going to be wiped out, y'all. Because of my eyes, I didn't put them back in right. So, but anyway, we're going to go ahead and adjust that. You want to put about, I say a shape of, I don't know, your pancakes are on you. It depends on how big you want them. Me, I don't want mine too big. I'm just going to make two good ones. I could make a third one. No, we're just going to make two good ones. And then while it's doing that, put that to the side. I like to go ahead and rinse that out because that pancake needs to do. Yep, and pretty washed, ready to be washed. So while that's going, I'm going to turn things up a little bit to go ahead and end this process. We should be eating about 2 or 3 minutes. It's looking good, y'all. Putting things up over here. And I'll be able to sit down and talk to you for a minute or so. Pour me a little coffee. Got the coffee going already, y'all. Yes. Give me just a second. Be right back. And what are some of you guys' plans today? Me, y'all be doing a little homework and be live most of the day, all day. Anyhow, I'm not going to be live this morning because I understand everybody got things to do. Maybe you want to sleep late, but I'll be coming back on because, like I told you, y'all know y'all are my peeps, my loyal people. Y'all start going live every day. So that's just the way it is, y'all. Got to get that watch hour time. And I lost some subscribers, guys. Yeah, I don't know if it's a purge or you guys just don't like my stuff, but I don't worry about them numbers. I get there when I get there. The most important thing about me, I like networking. I love YouTube, period. But most of all, I love cooking for and making friends with the people I have, like Mad Max, my boy. Say, Mad Max, he's a man with a master plan, y'all. Y'all see me over the Abandoned Boys. You'll see me. Mad Max is an outstanding YouTuber. He has the most best game graphics. I mean, paranormal. Y'all should check him out, y'all. Mad Max, he's a man, y'all. I'm telling you, he's a legend. Next to Angry Grandpa, I think he's next in line. Y'all know I love me some Angry Grandpa. Keep behind the camera, the Green family. Charleston, South Carolina, AAP, A View with a View, Abandoned Boys, Mad Max, D9, Tony, what's up? Yeah, that type of stuff. Feel me? G-Kicks. AP 420, Byron chilling with Byron up in the house productions. Those are my peeps. Jesus Freak God, the good one. Just to name a few. But anyway, y'all, these eggs looking mighty fine. So we go ahead and turn these off. And I just want them to just sit there because of what is happening now is all that grease is coming out. So now with the pancakes, getting back over here, I'm going to turn up a little bit, put the grits on 3. We're going to eat in a minute, y'all. Trust me. So right now, I'm just waiting for the pancakes to form. I'll show you guys what it looks like. Here we go, y'all. And basically, when you see those little tiny holes that begin to form around the pancake, You see, it's two there. Actually, I'm gonna make it four small pancakes. Well, you want to wait till the little holes just start percolating. You feel me? Yes. So a lot of people like to call these Johnny cakes. Mine's gonna be pie cakes. I'm gonna cut it like a pie. So what I'll do right now is take my handy dandy pancake spatula. If you get one of these, they're very excellent for lifting all the excess oil out of any ingredient. But anyway, I got one person watching. Can I get a thumbs up from me, Mad Max, if you don't mind? It's free. It lets me know how good I'm doing on my channel. You know, likes, share, subscribe. Mad Max is my moderator, one of my many moderators. I mean, guys, when I say moderators, I got the best mods in the world, honey. We're talking about the top echelon of YouTube. I got Miss Fucking Wonderful. I got Bending Boys. I got Mad Max. I got Chilling with Byron. God's a good one. Jesus a freak. Should I go on? Yep. But tell me, you see anybody in blue here? Trust me, they know YouTube. They knew you know YouTube. If anything, I'm the baby of all of them. They teach me all the time. Because I'm telling you, when I first started YouTube, I used to cuss people out because I didn't know that YouTube could be so cruel, you know? So I've learned to sit back and chill like Mad Max, Coke 49, the Bandit Boys. Let trolls be trolls. That's a better way to handle people. Just ignore them. They want to cut up, then they know not to cut up. Yeah, and these pancakes, I'm going to put them on this eye. How about that? You can see it better. Because this eye is just not getting hot as I want to because it's not pushed all the way in. But I will take care of that problem when we're done cooking. But right now, I'm going to let them sit there and see how it's just uneven, y'all. I don't like that. But anyway, we will do it what we have. And what I'm doing right now, guys, is taking the four pieces of pancakes and flipping them right now. I'm making little miniature pancakes. You know, y'all know what I'm saying? Where you just flip it and flatten it out. So right about now, I probably got like five little small pancakes, and it's making a mess, y'all, because I should have made it a little thicker, but it's going to do what it's going to do. People hungry, they'll eat, honey. Trust me. As long as it ain't burnt, they'll eat it. And I'll let that, there we go, and I can put it back on this side. And I'll let it just go ahead and simmer. Not simmer, but get brown, honey. While that's happening, I'm going to go ahead and get my plate ready. Oh, Lord, honey, y'all, it's getting hot already. I'm going to go turn the air conditioner on while that's doing it, and I'll be right back, y'all. But anyway, today's going to be a beautiful day. I'm running the water into the pool. I'll be swimming all day, going live with Katie and my pups. Just having a good time. Feel me? But anyway, just turn the air conditioner on. Oh, yeah. Just turn the air conditioner on, y'all. And now what we're going to do, y'all, is go ahead and get ready for breakfast in about 2 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and get the plates out, but right now I got time to straighten up a little bit before my mom and pops get over here. Now, y'all keep in mind, my dad passed away, but my mom got a new boyfriend. We call it Pops. His name is Pop Bennett, so we call it Pops. But I call my dad, so, you know, if I say Pop, anytime I'm looking at the pool, boy. That boy red bad boy ready to go. I'm ready to get in my swimming pool, y'all. Swimming suit. Go swimming. But anyway, let's go ahead and get this breakfast going, y'all, because I'm ready to eat. Hope you guys have a wonderful Saturday. And I think you were spending time in Carolina Diamond's kitchen, y'all. But this is what we're going to do. I'm going to go ahead and get one pancake. Yeah, I'm going to show you what it looked like. Yes. And I want a little bit extra myself, not much, just a little bit. So what I'll do, I got to get that up too, guys. I'll pick this up, and I'll shake all the little oil out of it. Yeah, I eat like a fist-sized portion because I am definitely going to finish this diet because I got to look good by July the 7th, y'all. Please believe me. Then I'll get me a little bit of grits. Yeah, I cooked about 6 people today. Now, the grits, guys, is Quaker. Grits, and basically I'll just stir it up a little bit, put a little milk in it, and it smells fabulous. Now I'll take me about 3 tablespoons because I believe in watching my weight, because I am not going to get out here and ruin my diet, honey. I'm too far to lose this weight sitting around broke legs and stuff, you know, couldn't work out. But now I'm up and standing. And guess what I did last night? My ass went in and washed the washing machine, fell on my finger, and y'all look, I think I pretty much messed my finger up. Boy, life of a soldier. I'm glad I can have two kids. I'm glad that I can take a little bit of pain, but that shit hurt, y'all. Y'all excuse my language, but I said worse than that last night. So I'm going to put this back on the eggs. Okay. I thought it took my utensils out and go ahead and wash them. I really do. Man, eggs are fabulous, y'all. Put this inside the stove. So when it comes open, and go ahead and eat. My finger, it's hard for me to open the stove, too. Yeah. So what I'm going to do now, go ahead and clean up the mess up top of the stove. Can't stand a dirty kitchen, y'all. I really can't. All right, y'all. Y'all, the one thing y'all probably knows that I didn't do, I didn't put any salt in it. I don't like a lot of salt. I really don't. That's probably why I crumble all the time, because my body always needs salt. But for today's purpose, I'll put a little bit on it. And I'm the type of person, I let people put their own salt on anything. I cook like the hospital. Tastes great, but it needs salt. So I'm going to go ahead and sprinkle a little bit, because I don't like that much salt. Just a little bit. Put it back up. Go ahead and get the wood out. Ain't your mama, baby. And I don't like to put a lot of butter on my stuff because the butter is already inside. As you can see, I substitute the olive oil for a little bit of margarine today. Normally, I can't believe I butter, but I got to go to the grocery store, y'all. It's been so hot, I'm like, hell with it. I'm not going to the grocery store. I hate going grocery shopping, especially when it's really hot. Woo, people just get outrageous when it's hot, honey. People are already going crazy because of the epidemic. And now people fighting over masks and stuff. I'm like, man, I'll get there when I can. It ain't no hurry, but you got to get food. But anyway, let's taste this food, y'all. As y'all can see, I got my grits, got my pancakes, and I got my cheese and eggs. And yes. Let's take a see how it is. Ooh, this plate is hot, y'all. My finger hurting, too. Let's taste it. Y'all. Still slamming. Y'all. I don't mean to be rude, but I'm telling you, Sister Girl is hungry. Happy Juneteenth Day to all of y'all. Afro-Americans, we free. Free at last. Free at last. Thank God we free at last. Power to the people. All lives matter to me, but today is our day. Power to the people. Black power. Love this day. But when we get to heaven, God ain't gonna care about skin color. He gonna say, I care about your soul. So I'm gonna say this. Happy Soul Day, my brothers and sisters. Bon appetit. Y'all. Much love, y'all. Peace. Thanks for stopping by, Mad Max, and eating breakfast with me. Much love, baby. I'm going to check you out today. Y'all, everybody go check out Mad Max, because I am. Peace.